If you're a complete beginner to Blender, welcome. This video series will show you how to create this scene here, some donuts and some coffee, whilst also walking you through some of Blender's very basic features from a beginner's perspective. So you'll go from being a complete beginner, like never having touched the software before, to understanding the very basics, modeling, materials, lighting, and things like that. So I know that you are probably busting to get started in Blender, but since this is part one, I want to take 60 seconds to just quickly address what this video series will discuss and what it won't. So Blender can do a lot of stuff, like too much stuff. There's a lot of features here that only like a fringe group of people will ever use. Like some people use Blender for like visualizing MRI scans, you know, and like the stuff that they use, like most people will never touch. So if you're familiar with the 80-20 rule, it's that 80% of the results come from 20% of the actions, or in this case, in terms of software, they come from 20% of its features. So I believe that in 3D, the 20% of features that everybody uses, regardless of whether you're in 3D printing, VR, visual effects, animation, any of that stuff, everybody uses modeling, materials, and lighting. And so that's the focus of this video series. It's to help you go from being a complete noob of Blender to, first of all, understanding the interface, which is pretty important, to modeling something, creating a completely new shape out of something else, adding materials, and then adding lighting. So once you've learned this, you can then create your next first scene. So we're going to be going through the basics, and throughout this, we're going to be also creating this scene as well. So you'll both be, learning Blender from a new perspective whilst also working towards this final image here of these donuts and a coffee. So this is part one. So we're going to be doing just some very, very basic stuff in this video, just moving around Blender and, just showing you the very introduction of the interface. But if you stick to the very end of this video, just for something fun, because I know we're going through some dry stuff at the start. If you stick to the end, I'll show you how to create a fiery monkey head, just as a little fun thing right for the end there. So if you haven't done it already, go to blender.org, download Blender, and install it. I won't show you how to do that because I don't want to insult your intelligence. And also, I'm pretty sure a lot of people have already done that. So, yeah. Welcome to Blender. Now, if you're itching to explore Blender, feel free. Click all the buttons. Because the good thing is that you can't really break it. Like, maybe you change everything. To the point that, like, even the developers are like, what did you do? Like, it's unrecognizable from the default Blender. Well, if you go to File, New, it restores the default layout. So Blender, like Photoshop, like if you've used it and then like you change like a toolbar or a panel or something like that, and you're like, oh no, where did it go? And so you restart the program hoping that it'll come back again, and it doesn't. Well, Blender's not like that. So the layout it's saved into the file. So like, yeah, if you change the layout or whatever, you can just restore it by going back to your last file, or in this case, the new scene. So point being, if you're new to the software and you want to check out like all the little features in that, like feel free, like click everything. And then, at the end of it, you can just, just start up a new scene and, fine and dandy. So that's that. So after you've done clicking around, let's talk about what these different things are. So this area right here in front of you, this is called the 3D viewport. And probably 95% of what you do in Blender is done right here. So if you're making a character, you do it here. If you're modeling a car, you do it here. If you're building a scene, you do it here. This area here is, it does a lot. That's what this area is right here. Now on the right-hand side, all these little buttons here, this is called the properties area. And this is where you generally change information of the 3D viewport. So like, for example, this cube here, like, oh my goodness, that'd be the wife. I'll answer that one later. That'll be fine. So with this cube here, like say I went to the, that should be on Do Not Disturb. I don't understand the iPhone. If you selected the cube and you went to the materials panel and you made that color there red, hey, lo and behold, it's made the cube red. So that's just an example. Like, yeah, the stuff that you change that you do here in the 3D viewport, you can change it in the properties panel. Okay, so that's the basics of that. Now, moving around in the 3D viewport is done with your middle mouse button. So if you click and hold that in, you are now orbiting. So we are now sort of rotating around 360 degrees of your scene. Now, this orbiting function, I remember when I first started, it was very, like there were times when I was like, I did that and I'm like, oh, what's going on? Everything is upside down. And it was like, so jarring. So the thing to remember is if you get into an area like, you're like, I don't know where I am, you can use the, on your number pad, if you hit 7, that takes you to, oh, actually, I should make sure I turn on my screen keys tool so you can actually see what I'm pushing there. Okay, if you hit number pad 7, that takes you to the top. If you hit number pad 1, that takes you to the front. If you hit number pad 3, it takes you to the side. Okay, so 7, 1, and 3. By the way, if you're on a laptop right now and you don't happen to have a number pad, shame on you. Get yourself a laptop with a number pad. No, I know. I got a MacBook Air and it's the same. So if you are on a laptop, just go to File, User Preferences, and then underneath Input, click Emulate Number Pad. And also if you wanted to emulate your, like, what's it called? Like the middle mouse button. You could click emulate 3-button mouse and then you control left click and then you'll do that. But honestly, you should get a mouse if you're using Blender, at least get a mouse. But anyways, click number pad and then click save user settings if you're on a laptop. Otherwise, you're fine, okay? So, look at that. So now we're moving around. We're looking at the top view, looking at the front, whatever. Now, let's say we don't want to have to look at the cube right now. What our focus is on is that right there, which is the camera. Well, it's kind of annoying to bring that into focus. So the way that you would have a look at that is by holding down shift and then middle mouse button dragging. And now we're sort of moving the view, we're shifting the focus to a new area. Now it's kind of like weird, like you first move it and it's like, oh, that's not the center, like the camera's up there now. So like, because it's 3D view, it doesn't really know where you're trying to look at until you sort of, by a number of movements, find your way there, if this is making any sense at all. So now we're sort of looking at the camera there. Now if I wanted to have a look at the lamp, and by the way, this is good practice, just especially as you first start, go from, yeah, having a look at the camera to now having a look at the lamp. Now I'm going down to have a look at the cube here. And now we're looking at the old cube. Thrilling stuff, I know. This is, you're probably thinking like, this is 3D? Oh my goodness, what have I done? This is the most boring thing. I know it's boring, but it's the start, you know. You break off the dry piece of bread and then underneath is the moist stuff. Put that on a bumper sticker. All right. So yeah, so we're moving around. Okay, so that's good practice, all right? Good practice. I won't be checking your homework, but if you can sort of just move from object to object, it's good practice. Now, there is actually an easier way to, like, don't think you have to do that for everything. So say I was on this cube and I wanted to look at that camera over there. Well, first of all, I would select the camera, which you'll notice, if you click anywhere in Blender, you click, you're not selecting it. You got this dumb little, it's called the 3D cursor. I shouldn't call it dumb, it has a purpose, but it's annoying. You click and it's like, there's that thing there. Why is that? Well, for whatever reason, Blender is a little bit silly in that the left and the right mouse buttons are sort of flipped, okay? So default with Blender to select something is right click, which I personally believe is a little bit silly. And I even did a whole video series explaining it and 90% of the community voted that it should be changed. And from what I heard, in the future, it is going to be changed. By default, it'll be left click. For now, what I suggest you do, especially as a beginner, because it'll help you, it's just one less thing to think about, is to change the default to be left click. And you can do that by going to File, User Preferences, and then click Select with Left. And then when you do that, hit save user settings. Oh, I'll uncheck that so I don't have that. Okay. And now that you've done that, hey, now you can select just like you would in any other program, just makes it a lot easier. And you're now ahead of the curve so that when Blender does change to default to left, you are already on the same page. Okay. So we've selected something. We select the camera. If we want to have a look at that thing, instead of dragging our way over there piece by piece, if you hit number pad period, ta-da, now it brings that directly to the focus. Now I can select the lamp. Now I'm looking at the lamp. Now I select the cube, and now I'm looking at the cube. Okay, so those are some very basic things. So we discussed in this part one, which was very dry and very, you know, boring, orbiting with middle mouse click, panning with shift middle mouse click, top view, which is 7, front view, which is 1, side view, which is 3. Oh, one extra one, by the way, just to make it interesting. If you push number pad 5, that takes it from perspective mode to orthographic mode or back and forth like that, which don't, if you're a complete beginner, don't worry about that yet. Like, oh, well, what's the difference? It's just, like users of other software might be more familiar with orthographic or vice versa. So you can switch between them. And it comes in handy when you're modeling something like the size of a building, you want to get it the exact size, you would switch in and out of it like that. But anyways, don't worry about it otherwise. So yeah, so 7, 1, 3 to the side, that to switch in and out of it. To focus on something, you are clicking and then number pad period. And we also inverted the settings to what it should be, left click as select. So again, this is just part one. I just want to do some very, very basic stuff just to start. To make things interesting, I did mention that we would set a monkey head on fire. So let's do that right now. So let's delete this default cube. And I'll just show you the next thing in Blender. So to bring another object into the scene, you do this by hitting Shift A. Okay, so that's brought up this menu here, which has a range of different stuff. A lot of them you would never want to use, really. Like Speaker, I guess that's used for games. Force Field, that's for like physics simulations and stuff. The majority of what you would use is underneath Mesh. So these are, other software sometimes call them primitives. It's just a basic object. So Sphere, you click Sphere, brings in a sphere. You can, and Delete, you can just hit Delete. And then took that away. I'm not sure if I addressed that before. But anyways, so you can bring in any of these objects here. Another shortcut for delete is X, by the way. Just hit X. So you can bring in a bunch of these. Now, right down the bottom there's one called Monkey. What's the deal with the monkey, Andrew? Well, Monkey is, it's kind of like a cult figure of Blender. And it's used mostly for like material tests. Like you want to test a material, you just bring in a monkey. But it's sort of like this cult icon of Blender. So if you look at like some renders that people make online, like you see like a forest scene, you're like, ah, it's a cool forest. And they're like, wait a minute. And you like zoom in and like, I recognize that rock. And it's, of course, it's the monkey head. So like Blender used to try and like slip it into their scene as kind of like a little Easter egg. So that's kind of fun, but that's basically it. It's a monkey. And for whatever reason, it's called the Suzanne head. I don't know where that name came from. Let me get a drink here for a second. Okay, so let's set the Suzanne head on fire. So you can do this very, very quickly. If you hit the space bar, which is another shortcut, it allows you to type in anything, like maybe select. You forget then like what the keyboard shortcut is. You can just type it in, like what's the snap cursor to the center? And you can just do that. But the one that we're going to do, just for a bit of fun, because I know we did some dry stuff, let's set it on fire by clicking Quick Smoke. And what that does is it performs a number of actions for you very quickly. So it created this smoke simulation based around the object that was selected, which was the monkey head. And now if you hit Alt-A, which is another shortcut, it's rendering, it's simulating the smoke. Which is kind of cool. And if you really wanted to, this isn't include, like this is just extra advanced stuff. I've got a whole tutorial on fire simulation, by the way, if you wanted to check it out later on. But in the physics panel here, you've got options like you could make it like high resolution smoke so that now it's like you get more plumey smoke, which is kind of cool. You could make it higher resolution. So it's like nicer looking smoke. And also, if you select the Suzanne head and then change the smoke type to fire and smoke, hey, now it's a crazy flaming head like out of that Nicolas Cage movie. What's that one? That motorcyclist one, the one that looks like the only people that enjoyed it were like the same guys that are at NASCAR. I don't know, Ghost Rider. That was, and he's like, I'm the Ghost Rider. I just scared my cat. Anyway, that was it for part one. Now, I discussed a lot of keyboard shortcuts in this video. A lot of them. Now, if you're struggling to remember it, don't worry about writing notes because there is a free keyboard shortcut PDF on my website. So if you click here right now, just go to the website and then type in your email address and I'll send that to your inbox. So it's a handy little guide. It's got all the common shortcuts in three pages, all the common shortcuts that most artists use, and it's printer friendly. So you can print it out, stick it on your wall, and enjoy. So that was part one. Hope you learned something. Click here to join me in part two right now, and let's get into it.